So everyone, today I am going to tell you about numeric functions. Okay, as you can see, the numeric functions, they are used to perform mathematical calculations, like you can calculate the product, you can calculate the remainder value, you can calculate the power values, you can calculate round off values, you can calculate the value equivalent to sine, cos or tan, SQRT, which stands for square root, truncate. Yesterday I told truncate, which is like a round function only, but actually in round function the value is rounded off, but in truncate the value is not rounded off, it is just removed. The decimal places are removed, only those places are required, which is only those places are taken which are required by us. And except that, there are date and time functions. Are you all able to listen to me?
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Numeric functions are also called mathematical functions. Yeah, date and time function. As yesterday I told some of the date and time functions. So in that we have the functions like current date, date function, month function, year function, day name, day of month, day of week, day of year, now function, SYS day. Okay. Except that in your CBSE syllabus, some more functions are given. That also I would like to tell you. Like these are the functions which is given in here in the book, or you can say the whole syllabus of the book. But now I think your syllabus has been reduced by CBSE. So in the reduced syllabus, the functions are not there. Some of the functions have been removed. Okay. So I am just going to show you the CBSE syllabus also. The screen is not responding. Just wait a minute. Yeah. You can see here the date functions. These are the date functions. Can you see the picture? Can you see the image?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So,
yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What are the functions provided by CBSE? In date function, we have now, date, month, month name, year, day, and day name. Okay. These are the different date functions given in the CBSE syllabus. And math function also. Here in the book, I told you there are many functions of math, mathematics. But here in CBSE syllabus, only three functions are given. Three functions, that is power, round, and mod function. Okay. So now let us talk one by one about the first numeric functions, then about the date functions. Okay. I show you with the SQL query. Yeah, so now we have numeric functions, or you can say mathematical functions. Now I'm going to share you with the SQL screen. Are you all able to see the SQL screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Can you see the SQL screen?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Prateek Singh, don't write anything on the screen.
Sir, galti se ho gaya, wo kya bole hum thoda.
Okay, now I'm going to show you the functions, mathematical functions, one by one. So we have first mod function. Okay, so what we write? We write the select command. Select space mod. Then we give two values. Okay, in mod function, two parameters are given. Parameter of two values. That is first the dividend, and then the second one divisor. Okay, so suppose we want to divide 11. Okay, 11 by 4. Now it will divide 11 by 4 and tell the remainder value. In mathematics, just we find the remainder. In the same way, it will find the remainder and give you the modulus value. Modulus, or you can say remainder. So press the semicolon and press enter key. Can you see what is the answer?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, the answer is 3. If you divide 11 by 4, so 4 to the 8, the remainder left 3. That's what here remainder has been given. The mod, or you can say modulus, is provided. Then we have the other function like power function. Okay. Remember, in SQL, you have to write select command. With every function, select command is compulsory. Without select command, no function of SQL can work. So you have to write select command. Select power, then in parentheses, the two values, parameter of two values. That is, you can say, we want to have the power value of 4. 4 raised to the power 2. Okay. So it will calculate 4 square. That means 16. You can see the result is 16. There is one more method. You can combine two functions. Like you can combine remainder as well as the power. So let us combine these two functions. Select. Let us first write power. Power of what? We can calculate mod. Mod function. See here, I'm combining two functions. Now we give the mod of what numbers? Two numbers. Suppose we want 11 or 15 divided by 4. Or any other number you can give. Let us give 17. So that more remainder left. Okay. 17 divided by 3. Then comma, the power value. How much power you want to raise? Suppose we want to raise 3 power. Now, can any one of you tell the answer?
8.
Yeah?
8.
Yes, the answer will
eight.
First, it will calculate the remainder. It will divide 17 by 3. That will come 2. Remainder will be 2. Then 2 will be raised to the power 3. That means 2 into 2 into 2. So the answer will be 8. Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes,
now
sir.
Have... Yes, sir.
Yes. Any problem?
No, sir.
No.
Okay, then we have SQRT function. SQRT stands for square root. So we can write SQRT. Select SQRT in parentheses. Write the number of which you want SQRT, square root. It requires only one value in the parameter. So suppose if we want the square root of 169. So it will provide the result as 13.
13.
Okay. Or you can have a square root of any other number. Suppose we want the square root of 150. Sorry, select command is not written. Select
Thirteen.
Sir, give any means. Yes,
okay.
Perfect, don't give any perfect square number.
Yes, sir.
So the square root of 150 is 12.247 something. Okay. Or you want other square root. Suppose you want square root of 289. 17. I hope you must remember the square root of some numbers. Can you tell me the square root of 225? 25. Yeah.
15.
Yes. 256.
16.
14. नहीं
16.
What then man?
196.
अरे
हाँ
196.
कुछ नहीं
14.
So like this you can remember if you practice you can remember the square root up to 20. I remember the up to 18-19. Okay. So like that you can calculate 20. The square root of different values by using the sqrt function. Next we have round function. Round function, sine function and truncate function. So let us calculate the sine value. Okay, select sine. You have studied, you must have studied in class 10th about sine values, cos values, tan values. Is it or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So suppose you want the sine value of 90.
3/5.
1.
30.
कहाँ पढ़े होते हैं?
अरे वो नहीं, हम उसका वो बोल रहे थे, मतलब आंसर नहीं बता रहे थे.
तब क्या बता रहे थे?
Sine value of 90, मतलब हम सोचा थे 9 something. I don't remember. You are studying mathematics. Some of the mathematics.
It is 1.
You can know very well.
0.8.
Okay. Other values you want to calculate, like you want to calculate the sine value of 50 minus 0.262, or you want to calculate the cos value. Okay, it is not given, cos function is not given, but you can use. Okay, select cos, then cos value of 90
zero
minus 0.44 something. Okay.
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
You want a cost value of 40 minus 0.66 something. Tan value, let us calculate tan value.
Sir, ye galat value dikha raha hai kya?
See, it is not calculating according to angle, okay? Not 90 degree or 50 degree or 40 degree. Is it clear? It is calculated
radian mein hai ye.
Somehow, I think log
kya
log ke hisab se hoga.
It is not calculating according to the angle. Okay, in class 10 we studied according to the angle, na? Tan 90, sin 90, cos 90. Is it
yes,
or not?
Sir, yes, sir. Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay, next is a chapter concept. Round function. Let us use round function. Select round. Now suppose we have the value 195.9837. Okay. Comma. Now how much digit you want to round off? You want to round off up to 2 digit or 1 digit or 3 digit?
3 digit.
One digit.
One digit, okay, if you take, okay. Then what will happen? Do you know?
One day.
It will become 196.0. Okay, let us take one digit. One digit, if you round off, that means it will provide after decimal only 1 digit. So after decimal, if you round off, so what will happen? Here is 8 and here is 9. So it will be rounded off to 10. That is 10. So, but it is carried. One is carried to this one. You must be right in mathematics. I need not explain. Okay. Press the semicolon and press enter key. So what is the result?
196.0.
Okay. Now if you round off to 2 digits or 3 digits, whatever you want. Now you can see the round off to 2 digit, 9.98. Why? Because there was after 8 there was 3. If there must be there would have been 5 or 7, then it could have come 9.99. Yes. Is it or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Now, if you take three digits, then it will come 0.984. Can you see 195.984?
Yes,
so this
sir.
Is the use
yes,
of sir. Round function. Any problem?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay. Then we have like round function, I told, truncate function. There is a truncate function. So what is the use of truncate function? It does not round off. It just takes the number of decimal what you have provided. If you have provided 2, it means it will take only 2 decimal digits. If you provide 3, then it will take only 3 decimal digits.
3 decimal digit.
Okay. So let us yes. write truncate function. Select truncate. Okay, then in the parentheses, write the value, some value you can write like 54.245. Okay, then comma, how much value you want to take after that decimal place, after the point. Suppose I want to take after point only 2 values. So it will not round off. It will just take two values after the decimal. That is 2 and 4. Now close the yes. parentheses and press semicolon. Okay, now you can see 54.24. That means truncate function is used to take the given decimal values. It does not round off. If you have given 2 digits, to take decimal value, so it will take only 2 digits after the decimal. Okay, this is all about the numeric functions, mathematical functions. Have you all understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now we have the date and time functions. So let me once again show you that function, date and time function. Can you not see the screen of photo picture?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, here are the date and time functions. So let us use one by one all these functions. Okay. Like for yes, current sir. Date, we write cur date, this function. For current date and time, sorry, to extract the date and time from the given date or time, we write date function. To extract the month from the given date, we write month function. To extract year from the given date, we write year function. To extract the day name, what is the name of the day of that date? We use day name function. To extract the day of month, that is a fourth number or sixth number day, which is the day? That is day function or day of month function. Day of week, that means in a week, you know, the counting starts from Sunday. Sunday comes to 1.
Yes, sir.
Monday, 2. Tuesday, 3. Like this, the counting starts, na? So, which day of the week yes, it sir. Is? For that, we use the function day of week. Day of year. So, as you all know, in a year, there are 365 or 366 days. So, in your date, which day is that? It will count overall and provide you the number that this is the 200 or 250th day or 203rd day, whatever. Now function, this function provides the current date and time from your system. In your system, what is the current date and time in your computer or in your mobile? What is current date and time? That is given by now function. SYS date, this also provides the current date and time.
There is difference a difference between.
I will tell you the difference between now function and SYS date function. Yes, minor difference is there. So I will tell by practical, okay?
Okay, sir.
And in your CBSE syllabus also there is given some of the function like month name, day name, date function, now function. So let us use these all functions, all date and time functions. Okay. Let me share the SQL screen.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, the functions we are testing is not given in book. So how will we study?
Which function?
I'm not getting. Please speak loudly.
All these.
It is given in the book.
Where page number?
Page number 319.
Okay.
Did you find?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
If not given, what? No problem. Tanmay. You can have extra knowledge. Tanmay.
I
am telling you more than your syllabus, not less than your syllabus. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So let us use the functions, date and time functions one by one. First, we have current date. So let us write what is the current date in our computer system. For that, we write the select command. Can you all see the SQL screen?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So write select command, then write cur date. Okay, then close the parenthesis, press semicolon and enter. See what is the current date in our in my laptop? 26 August 2020. Okay, now let us have date and time both. So current date and time we can have. For that we can write now function. Which function?
Now
function, select now, press semicolon. Okay, now you can see it is providing the current date as well as current time in my computer. What is the current time and date in my laptop? That is given by the now function. Okay, the current date 26 August 2020 and the current time is 11:55:46. Then we have a date function. Okay, let us write select date. Now date function, what does date function do? It just extracts the date in the given date and time. So let us give the date and time. Suppose the date and time is 2020. Okay, space hyphen August 26, or you can give other date also. I am just giving an example. You can give other date, other time. So let us write the time 11:55. Same time I am writing 46. Okay. Then close the parenthesis, press semicolon. Always remember the date and time will be written in single or double quotation mark. Okay. Now it will extract the date. It will extract. It will find out the date from the given date and time. And show before the screen. See here, from the date, given date and time, it has extracted or it has given the date.
Date.
Okay. Now the same thing. In the same thing, I can use other functions. Except date function, I can use other functions. What are the other functions? Month function. Okay. Which
yes,
month?
Sir.
Which month is there? So we can write month.
Month name.
I have given the date and time already. I have written month function. Now it will extract the month in the given date and time and show before you. So the month is 8. It is
eight.
The number of the month. Okay. In the same thing, you can write the month name. Which function?
Month name.
Month name.
Month
okay.
name. Yes, sir.
Month name. Any problem?
No, sir.
Yeah, you can write month name. Sure. Now it will provide the month name. What is the month name?
August.
Then you can write day name. What is the day name? What is the date? 26. Now what is the day of 26th August? That you can write day name. Okay.
Wednesday.
So it is giving Wednesday. Today is Wednesday.
Wednesday.
Yes,
sir.
Yes, sir. Then you can write
day of month.
Day of month. That is only already given. I think here month.
Yes, sir. Same only.
Same thing. Day you can write day function. Okay. Mm-hmm. If you write day function, it will provide only that only. Day of month or day function. Same thing. Okay. See what is yes, the day?
Happy.
Let us write that also. Day of month. Day of month. Okay. 26. Same thing.
Yes, sir.
Now let us write day of week. Day of week.
4.
In the current week, what is the day? Okay. So you can see 4. Wednesday is the 4th number day in a week. Like Sunday is the first number, Monday is the second number, Tuesday is the third number, mm-hmm. and Wednesday is the 4th number.
Fourth.
Then we have day of year. Day of
year.
Year. It is the 239th day in the year.
39, okay.
The year is maybe of 365 days or 366 days. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Then we have system date and time, SYS date. I had told now function and SYS date. Now it is the time mm-hmm. to tell the difference. So let me write SYS date. SYS date. Okay. Press semicolon. See, it is showing the current date and time of your system. Now the difference. If we write select now sleep. Function. Okay. Select now function. Then I write sleep. One time now function it will provide. Then I will write sleep for 2 seconds. I'm just giving the difference of 2 seconds. Then again I'm writing now function. Means now function I have used 2 times. One time it will provide the current date and time. Then it will sleep for 2 seconds. Then again it will provide the current date and time. So what you'll find that it will provide the same date and time.
Sir, you have used semicolon there.
Have you seen?
After.
There is problem.
Semicolon after now. Select now semicolon.
Yeah. Sorry. A very big mistake. There should be comma. I have given semicolon. There must be comma. Okay. Now comma, then sleep, yes, comma, then in last there will be semicolon. Now you see the 2 date and times, but there will not be gap of 2 seconds. I have given the gap of 2 seconds, but now function does not provide the gap. Okay. Can you see the 2 date and time?
Yes,
is there
sir.
Gap of 2 seconds in the time?
Yes, sir.
No, sir.
No. There are 2 seconds.
No.
It means no. The now function takes the current date and time only from first function, not from the second function. One time the now function has taken the date and time, that only it will display again and again. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
But this is not with the SYS function. SYS is different. Okay. We can write SYS date. And here also we can write SYS date. This is the minor difference. Okay. Now you see yes. there will be a difference of 2 seconds. Can you see?
Yes, sir.
Can you see the difference of 2 seconds?
Yes, sir.
Here is 12 yes, to 40 seconds. And here is 12 to 42 seconds. Did you find?
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
Yeah. So this is all about today's class. Let me take the attendance and then I finish. Okay.
Weather is getting bad.
Very bad.
ऐसा लग रहा है तुम शाम होगा ना?
Don't बात.
Don't बात करेंगे.
There are total 13 participants only.
Yes, sir. Including you.
12, 12.
Including you.
12 are there.
इतने ही है ना और कौन है
15 लोग 14 लोग हैं शायद
थैंक यू एवरीवन
एक वंश नहीं है
थैंक यू सर
थैंक यू सर